Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is your host, Gearjock, and welcome to another edition of the Academy. So today, I'm beginning the first in a series of videos dealing with different army build archetypes. For example, like infantry horde, control and denial, heavy armor, combined arms, just the kind of generic builds that work across all factions and are very effective. I'll probably do videos in the future dealing with faction-specific builds, but right now I'm still trying to put out videos that kind of appeal to everybody and kind of help everybody at once. So the first army type I'll be dealing with here is the kind of tank army, or heavy armor, or war beast heavy, or warjack heavy, however you look at it. But basically the idea behind the army is to capitalize upon most other models' inability to boost their damage rolls. This means that most models will be unable to hurt the army significantly, since all your stuff is going to be lots of armor and hopefully lots of hitboxes. This gives the tank army the ability to take and hold objectives while also having fewer targets to worry about in the opposing force, meaning that the opposing force is going to have a lot of units that are simply going to be ineffective against it. So only you have a few things in the enemy army that you need to kill before you have nothing to worry about. Because you have fewer models, it also makes it harder for your opponent to concentrate upon it. You can only get so many models attacking at one time. And if your opponent lacks a lot of hard-hitting models, it's going to be hard for him to bring up enough attacks to hit you with. Let me give a brief demonstration of that. So, you know, let's say I have this one heavy warjack up here, my centurion. Well, if I charge it, let's say with these sword knights, I'm going to be able to get about 5 of them on him. Well, that's nice and dandy. But if those 5 don't bring him down or kill him, I can't really bring anything else to attack that model. This becomes an even bigger problem if you have your models in some sort of formation, you know, whether it be, you know, large base models or medium base models like Man of Wars. You then get even less models attacking your models in the center. So, for example, this ironclad in the center, my opponent would only be able to get 3 of them on him. But then if you wanted to attack the model on the flank, he would only be able to get 3 on him as well. So he could either have just 2 attacking him or 4 attacking him, as opposed to the 5 individually. So the more you clump up, the harder it is for your opponent to concentrate his attacks against you. And it just kind of builds upon the theme of the force, of how it works. Now this army also has its weaknesses. The weakness of the tank list stem from the fact that it uses less models. Although an enemy may not be able to hurt the tank army, it can still easily delay and clog it up with a lot of cheap units. So, once again, although these sword knights may not be hurting your warjacks, you now have a 6-point unit tying up 16 points of models. And unless they get some support, it's really going to delay them, and that's very efficient for your opponent if he's trying to delay you from getting across the board to get some sort of objective. In addition, if you're playing a scenario where it requires you to split up your forces, well, then that also hurts you, because then the tank army can be more easily broken down and defeated. And generally, the way they typically function is by being this big ball of death. I'm sure many of you have seen trollbit armies like this, where they're all running around the big stone, so they're all getting their +2 armor. But the moment they break, well, then you're going to want to go after those models outside the bubble, since they're easier to kill. In addition, abilities that delay or stall really hurt the tank armies more than they might hurt other armies. For example, you know, let's say you have gun mages or druids or battle mages. using their ability to push models back. Well, if you're just pushing back little half-point mech thralls, you know, big whoop. But if you're pushing back a 9-point warjack or war beast and delaying it from getting up there, that's, you know, that's really hurting you for your overall points. You know, that might be close to a fifth of your points right there being delayed by one stupid model. So, you know, if somebody has spells like Haley with Temporary Barrier, then that really hurts you. Or, you know, you're fighting Nemo and he has Volteric Snare, and that stops your Warjack from advancing. Well, that really hurts. So, generally, you want to watch out for things like that, because that can be a very bad matchup. So, let's talk about the construction of this type of army. Your core is going to be a bunch of models with high armor and hopefully a lot of hitboxes. That's obviously the core, that's the whole concept behind it. You're trying to capitalize upon your enemy not having a lot of models that can boost their damage rolls. This concept also works with high defense. It's kind of the same thing. So if I had a Warp Wolf with defense 14, well, he's going to be really hard to hit for most infantry models since they can't boost a hit. And although he may have less armor, it's going to kind of equal out to be the same thing where he's being hit less but taking more damage as opposed to some heavy warjack that he's being hit more but taking less damage.